Welcome to the University of Southampton, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make the chemically perfect cup of mulled wine. To start with, we'll dissolve some sugar in a small amount of wine to make a nice thick syrup. So I'm going to take my sugar, and I'm only going to add just enough wine to cover the sugar. Now, the reason we're doing this is because we want to heat this quite hot. And as we heat it, the alcohol will evaporate at about 79 degrees, but we need it to be at that temperature to extract the oils from our spices. If we were to put all the wine in, we would then evaporate all the alcohol off. So what we do is we start with a small amount, disperse our oils in the wine, and then at the end, we'll top up to get a beautiful mulled wine taste. So I'm going to heat this using our stirrer hot plate. We're going to peel the skin of our lemons and clementines, and that is because most of the limonene present is in the skin. So by taking the skin and warming them in the wine, we're going to get the most limonene for our fruit and therefore the most flavour. So I'm just going to take the peeler and peel nice big chunks of the skin and pop them in our wine. And now that I've peeled these, we're going to put them to one side and I'm going to add the peel to our mulled wine. Okay, so now we're going to grind our cloves. And the reason we grind a lot of spices is to increase their surface area. As we know, when you have a larger surface area, you have more surfaces exposed to the mulled wine, so therefore more of the flavour can diffuse into the mulled wine. So to do that, I'm going to use a mortar and pestle. I'm going to tip my cloves in and get grinding. Now it's time to add it to the wine. Next, we're going to grate the nutmeg. Now, nutmeg has a combination of flavour molecules, camphene, pinene, and trimerostrin, all with their own unique properties. We're going to grate the nutmeg, again, to increase the surface area and increase the number of flavour molecules in our mulled wine. Okay, next we're going to add our cinnamon stick for that cinnamony taste. The main flavour is cinnamaldehyde. And cinnamaldehyde has antiseptic and antibacterial properties. Our next ingredient is vanilla, and the main flavour of vanilla is a molecule called vanillin. Now we're going to cut this pod in half. And again, that's to help release all the flavour molecules from inside. Now, vanillin is a very precious molecule, so much so that you can buy synthetic vanilla or vanillin. And originally, it was made from eugenol, which is the active ingredient in our cloves. Now, it's often made from a byproduct of paper waste or of tree bark. So our mulled wine is now ready. We're now going to add the rest of our wine and our star anise for a perfect finish. Okay. I'm using red wine, but you could use non-alcoholic wine or pomegranate juice. And our final ingredient to add is star anise, which has the taste very similar to licorice. Now, the molecule in star anise is anethyl, and it's 13 times sweeter than sugar, so it's that perfect little finish to make a lovely glass of mulled wine. I think it's done. So So the last step now is to get rid of all of those bits because all of our flavour molecules have diffused into the wine. And there you have it, a chemically perfect mulled wine.